Biblical Talks podcast with Michael Tolliver. This podcast is dedicated to biblical teaching and having worldview discussions from a biblical perspective. Here is today's podcast.
Second Timothy 3:12. Indeed, all who desire to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. Beloved of the Lord, I believe that we are beginning to move into a time in this country when it will cost you something to be a Christian. Melvin Laird, a U.S. congressman from Wisconsin, long before he was Secretary of Defense, made a statement at the San Francisco Republican Convention. Now, I don't know the circumstance which provoked this statement, but this is what he said. In this world, it is becoming more and more unpopular to be a Christian. Soon it may become dangerous. Now, he said this back in the early 70s. We are seeing this truth of this statement. Real Christianity and real Christians are becoming very unpopular. What I mean by real Christians are those who desire to live a godly life in Christ Jesus. Look at the speedy decline of our society. You can see what's happening even in the last 25 years. Look at the school shootings. Boys who think they are girls. Girls who think they are boys. Stuff that was once under the counter now is legal. It's right out in the open where kids can pick it up and go through it. Matter of fact, they look at it on their phones and computers. Look at our attitude towards morality. We now promote drag queens on primetime TV. People are addicted to drugs, alcohol, and whatever you can think of. And people are losing their minds. And this world is becoming more anti-Christian and anti-Christian values. The decline is happening so fast that a mother has to worry when she sends her child to school because she doesn't know if her child would be shot, raped, or killed. And what makes all this worse, it only gets 10 minutes in the news. God help us. If the Lord doesn't come soon, we are going to destroy ourselves. We are just going to sink in this filth. We are going to drown in our own corruption. Evil men and seducers will get worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. Listen. Paul not only shares his knowledge of persecution, but he warns Timothy that everyone living a godly life will experience persecution. And these persecution comes from outside the church, as seen through Paul's own experience in Antioch, but they also come from inside the church. Let me give you some examples. Cain murdered Abel because Abel did what was right in God's sight. Joseph was put in jail because he refused to sin against God. So he was persecuted. Daniel was put in the lion's den just because he prayed to his God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was fired because they refused to follow this world order. Listen, let me bring it home to you. If a wife submit to her husband, ask unto the Lord according to Ephesians 4:22, and she's not listening to her girls, she's not listening to a society telling her, you should be your own woman, you don't need a man, do what you want to do, that woman will be persecuted and canceled by this world, by many women, and even people in the church. They will hate you because you respect your husband and you yield to the word of God. If a man loves his wife as his own body, and he's not listening to his homeboys, he's having Bible study with his family at the dinner table. He is raising his family in the nurture and precepts of the Lord. That man will be persecuted by this world. Listen, if you believe in absolutes, according to the word of God, you will be persecuted. If you believe the moment a woman is pregnant, she has a life in her womb, you will be persecuted. If you believe the Bible is the word of God, you will be persecuted. If you believe that a man can't be a woman and a woman can't decide that she wants to be a man because that's how she feels, and because you believe that in the beginning God made them male and female, you will be persecuted. If you believe that a man is a sinner and there is nothing good in him, he has no righteousness of his own, he must turn from his sins and believe in Christ and Christ alone, faith alone, grace alone. If you believe that, you will be persecuted. If you are a faithful believer, you must expect persecution and suffering at the hands of a Christ-hating, Christ-rejecting world. Did not Jesus say, if the world hates you, you know that it hated me first before they hated you? If you were of the world would love its own. Yet because you are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. John 15:18-19. That's why I do not watch too much news. Listen, when was the last time you read a compassionate article on a biblical position? The media suffocate news that present real Christianity. If a fundamental preacher gets any PR, it will be distorted and misrepresented. Of course, now if a preacher get on the wrong side of the law, he will be on the front page. But if he saves a group of people from going to hell, he is discounted. Beloved Lord, we are moving to an area where Christianity and Christians may have to pay a price to stand for the faith. Living in this world as a disciple of Jesus is challenging because it involves many hardships. While not all believers will experience the same kind of problems or the same level of persecution, all of us will be persecuted if we want to live a godly life in Christ Jesus. If you go online to the VOM, which stands for the Voice of the Martyrs, you will see Christians all over the world who are being persecuted today. House churches are being raided. Pastors are being handcuffed in mid-service. Churches are being demolished. Christians were arrested, interrogated, and imprisoned. In verse 13, Paul referenced to evildoers and imposters are going to get worse. Now listen, people attack Paul, the church. People in the church attack Paul. So don't be shocked, upset, or disturbed when people in the church attack you. Likewise, Christ was criticized and killed by the religious establishment of his day. And we will experience this in the 21st century church as well. There will always be people in the church without true faith who oppose the truth. Not only will there be persecution from without and from within, but also spiritual warfare. We remember that Job's tribe was attacked from Satan, which came simply because he was righteous. He suffered finance loss, family loss, physical suffering, which was all demonic in its origin. Let's consider Paul's words again. All who wants to live godly lives in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. A pastor once said, if you're going month after month, year after year, and there are no negative repercussions that ever comes upon you because of your faith, then your faith has not been clearly demonstrated. You are a secret agent Christian or a spiritual CIA member. You are a covert operative because there has been no repercussions for your faith. To put it another way, if you are accused of being a Christian, would there be enough evidence to convict you of being a Christian, or would you be found innocent of all charges of being a Christian? Think about that. Beloved, if you and I align our lives with God, we are going to find ourselves out of alignment with this world, and persecution will come. Peter said in 1 Peter, consider it not strange concerning the fiery trials which are to try you, as though some strange thing has happened to you. So don't expect the world to speak well of you or to applaud you for your living a godly life and taking a righteous stand. They are not. Beloved, if you seek to be a visible and spoken follower of Jesus Christ, give your commitment to his kingdom agenda in every area of your life, you will face significant hostility from the devil and the world. In the very next verse, Paul said, evil people will only become worse. It's not going to get better. But I do have some good news. In 2 Corinthians 1, verse 3 and 4, listen to these words that Paul wrote. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comfort us in all our affliction, so that we may be able to comfort those who are in any affliction with the comfort which we ourselves are comforted by God. That's some good news. If anyone assures you that you can avoid suffering like health problems, mental anguish, relationship difficulties, or financial stress, or anything like that, if you have enough faith, they are not telling you the truth. Paul was a follower of Jesus Christ who stood head and shoulder above all other Christians in terms of his faithfulness, and he suffered greatly, not in spite of his faith, but because of his faith in obedience to Christ. Our suffering is directly related to God's purpose of using us to minister to others. We must not be so overcome by our suffering that we miss the unlimited comfort that God makes available to us in every circumstance. God is sovereign over our suffering, our trials, and our tribulation. Don't catch him off guard. When Jesus promised his disciples that they would undergo suffering, he also told them, be courageous. I have conquered the world. So take up courage, my brothers and sisters. Christ has conquered this world. So, beloved, be of good cheer. the God of all comfort will comfort us in all our affliction because he loves us. Have a blessed day.
For listening to Biblical Talks. This podcast is solely supported by listener donations. Please go to biblicaltalks.com to support this podcast and have a blessed day.